Hi guys, welcome to Code Artisan Lab. This is video number 4 for learning management system in Django and React.js. This is actually video number 3 because I have started this from 0. Okay, so this is 0, 1, 2 and this is the video number 3. Okay, but if you see the serial number then this is the 4. Okay, whatever you can assume 3, you can assume 4. Okay, so in this video, what we are going to do, in this video, we will create the database structure for our project. Okay, in our previous video, we have connected MySQL with Django. But in this video, we will create database structure and we will see that how to migrate and how we can do this. Okay, so let's start. So first of all, I have created here app main. So I will use this main app for my whole project. Okay, you can create different app for like your teacher panel, student panel, website, but I'm going to use this main app for our whole project, or you can say our API. Okay, so I will open main and I will open models.py file. So this file is responsible for creating your database structure. Okay, now we will create, first of all, we will create the teacher module. Teacher model, you can say class teacher. Okay, you can name it instructor or whatever you want. Okay, then we will models dot model, we are extending this class. Then here we will define the fields. So the first field is, I will say full name, and this will be cat field, and in this max length is required. Okay, so without max length you can't create the care field. Okay, so full name, then email address. Okay, so this is the email address, so you can define the care field as well. Then we will move on password. Okay, so this will be a care field also. Okay, and here we will define another field, full name, email, password, then qualification. Okay, this will be, let's define the length 200. Okay, this is qualification. Then we will define mobile number. This is detail of teacher. Okay, so mobile number, you can say this is 20. Then we can define address. We can add more fields or we can alter these fields as we require, but these are the basics. Okay, so we can for address we will use text field. Okay, we don't need to define the length or whatever, we can just simply add text field for the address. Okay, so full name, email, password, qualification, mobile number and address. Okay, so so We will create another model for teacher later. Okay, now what we will do, now we will create courses. So, okay, so this will be course model. Okay, so the first is, okay, so we will create course after the category. So this will be course category. Okay, so in the course category, we need title of the course and description of the course. Okay, so I will say title and here I will say description. Okay, so this will be title, like you can say 150. Okay, so course category. Okay, now course, this will be course category model. Okay, and this will be course model. In the course model, we need to define, because every course related to the category. Okay, every course will join with category. So category equal to models dot foreign key. Okay, I am defining the relationship. So this will be course category. This will be course, not this thing. Okay, so course category and on delete. So what it will do? If we delete the category, then it will delete the courses. Okay, So on delete models dot cascade. We don't need these things. Okay. So course category, now we will define the title and description. Okay, I will alter this model later. I will alter this model later because we need to add lots of things. And one more thing here I am going to add. So this course belongs to any, this course will belong to one of the teacher. Okay, so this will be teacher. So here we will define teacher. Okay, so title, description. Okay, so this is the things. Now let's define the student panel. So this will be similar as a, this you can say student. Okay, so full name, email, password, qualification. Okay, and we will also add interested category, or you can say categories. Okay, here we will put the here we will fetch the categories, and we will ask the student for the interested category, so that we will recommend courses according to the interested categories. Okay, so that I'm saving this field. Okay, so this is just a basic. We will of course we will alter this, we will add more fields, and we will alter these things. Okay, let's start with this, then we will make changes in our way. Okay, so what we will do, first of all we will create here the model, then we will migrate that, then we will assign this model to the admin. Okay, so let's define this. I will just close the server, then pymanage.py make migrations here. So now pymanage.py migrate. Okay, this is again saying the strict mode something. Now let's go to PHP my admin. So I have started my MySQL from my XAMPP server, and I am going to start localhost PHP MyAdmin. Okay, I need to start Apache also, because without Apache it will not work, because Apache is HTTP server, and if I am using the PHP MyAdmin, then I need HTTP server. I will close this. Okay, so here it is, LMS. And here you can see that main, this is the app name, and this is the our model name. Okay, so main students, main teacher, courses, course and course category. Okay, and in this, if you go to the course, then we have two fields. The first one is title, first one is ID, that is a primary key, it is auto created by the Django, and title, description, category ID, teacher ID. Okay, so this is created. Because we have defined the foreign key relationship. Okay, so okay, so we have created these models. Now in our next chapter this is not finished yet. We need to add these models to our admin panel. So I will open admin.py file here, and I will import all the models. So from dot import models. If you are listening the firecrackers sounds, then I don't know why somebody is okay, no issues. So this will be class, this is a class, and then we will register this. So how we can do that? admin.site.register, and here we will need to define the model. So models dot, so what it is, models dot teacher. Okay, so models dot teacher, then similarly we will define all the models here. So course category, then we will define course. This is just basic. I know if you are not understanding, then please watch this video 2 to 3 times, then you will understand. And I know we need to modify lots of things, so I am doing the things step by step. Okay, maybe this series become long, but I just want to explain each and everything very well so that you can understand everything. Okay, so here we are at registering the admin. Okay, now what we will do, we will open our admin panel. We need to restart the server. I don't want to just run this command manage.py run server. Okay, now we will check this. So this will be admin, and then I will put the password. Okay, I understand the issue. Actually, we have changed our database so that it is saying this thing. We need to create super user again. Okay, so py manage.py create super user. I have created already in my second video, but we have changed the database in our previous video so that it is saying we need to define this. So let's define this. So with the help of this create super user command, you can create the admin. Okay, now we have defined. Now let's run the server, and I will try to log in again, and just I have logged in. And here you can see that we have course categories, courses, students, and teachers. So here you can see that this is the weird thing, that course categories spelling is not proper showing. What we will do here, we will create class meta. This is for modifications. Okay, meta, and then we will say verb boss plural name, and the plural name is course categories. Okay, so now let's refresh this page. Why it is saying verb boss plural name, verb boss name plural, maybe. Refresh the page, and here you can see that course category. Okay, if you want to sort this, then this very easy, it is very easy to do. I will just copy this thing, and I will just name one teachers, because this will sort alphabetically. Okay, so I will say this is course category. Now I will define here courses, and this is number 3. Okay, and now I will define students. Okay, and of course I will explain you that without this number, how we can sort the model in our admin panel. Okay, we will also do that thing. So here you can see that number 1 teachers, course categories, courses, and students. Okay, by default it will add the CRUD operation. If we add the model in our admin, then by default it will add the CRUD operation. If you go to the teachers, then you can add the data according to that fields, according to these fields. Okay, so let's define this. So you can see that this is text field, this is character field, this is text field. Okay, and you can define all the things. There are lots of model fields here. You can search check the documentation, Django documentation. You will find lots of things. Okay, so we have created the models, basic structure of our database, and we have defined our models in admin. If you have any doubt, any comments, then anything you have doubt, then please add in the comment section. Okay, and I hope you understand all the things. If you have any issue, then please add in the comment section. And yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Please share, subscribe, like this channel. I will, so that I will create lots of more projects in Django, React.js, and many more technologies. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.